In the previous class, we already discussed about few properties of the rational numbers. Let us have a brief recap about those properties. Here, the first property is the closure property. What the closure property says here, if you consider any two rational numbers and if you add those rational numbers, you have to get the result is also a rational number. That property we call it as a closure property. What is the next property? Commutative property. Let us consider two rational numbers. And if you add those rational numbers and if you change the order, you have to give the result as the same. That property we call it as a commutative property. What is the next property? Associative property. For associative property, we need three numbers. Let us consider those rational numbers as A, B, C. And what this property says here? A plus of B plus C must be equal to A plus B plus C. And what is the next property? Role of zero. This role of zero, we call it as an additive identity. What this property says here, if you consider any rational number, you have to add one number such that you have to get the result as the same number. What is the number you have to add it here? Zero is the number you have to add. That zero we call it as an additive identity. So here what the property says, if A belongs to Q, then A plus 0 is equal to A, that must be equal to 0 plus A. And what is the next property? Role of 1. We call this one as multiplicative identity. Here what this property says here, if you consider any rational number, you have to multiply one number such that you have to get the result as same. Which number you have to multiply here? You have to multiply here 1. If you multiply it 1, you are getting the result as same. That one we call it as a multiplicative identity. What it says, if A belongs to Q, then A into 1 is equal to A. This one we can write it as 1 into A. That property we call it as a role of 1. Up to this we discussed in the earlier class, and here I mentioned only for the operation addition. Yesterday class we discussed about the subtraction, multiplication and the division. Now in this session we are going to discuss these three properties. So what is the next property here? Additive inverse. What is this property says here? If you consider one rational number, here let us take few examples here. 5. You have to add one number such that you have to get the result as 0. Which number we are adding here, that we call it as a additive inverse of the given number. Now let us consider few examples here. Let us consider 3 by 5. You have to add one number such that you have to get the result as 0. Now consider few negative numbers here. Consider minus 3 by 5. You have to add one number such that you have to get the result as 0. And minus 1 by 2. The same. You have to add one number such that you have to get the result as 0. Which number you have to add here such that you are getting the result as 0? Just you have to take the negative number of the given number. Here just you have to change the symbol of the given number. Here consider plus 3 by 5. Which number you have to add here? Minus 3 by 5. If you add minus 3 by 5, you are getting the result as 0. Now consider minus 3 by 5. Here we are considering the negative number. Which number you have to add it here so that you are getting the result as 0? You have to add here the positive number. So here which number you have to add? 3 by 5. Similarly here which number you have to add it here? 1 by 2. So what this property says here, if you consider any rational number, you have to add one number such that you have to get the result as 0. That number we call it as an additive inverse. So here what is the additive inverse of minus 5? 5. And what is the additive inverse of 5? Which is minus 5. Now how do you define this one? Here consider one rational number A, and what is this property says here? A plus of minus A must be equal to minus A plus A is equal to 0. This property we call it as an additive inverse. Here in the examination they will ask what is the additive inverse of 5. Then we can say that the additive inverse of 5 is minus 5. Suppose they will ask what is the additive inverse of 1 by 9. Then the additive inverse of 1 by 9 is minus 1 by 9. Like that you have to mention. And here, so how do you write this one here? A is the additive inverse of -a, or we can write -a is the additive inverse of a. Like that you can mention. Here they will ask what is the additive inverse of 1 by 9. Then you can say that the additive inverse of 1 by 9 is minus 1 by 9. And like this you can solve. What is the next property here? Multiplicative inverse. Next property is multiplicative inverse. Here, what this property says, let us consider few examples. After that, we will define the definition of the multiplicative inverse. Consider one number 3. You have to multiply one number. Why we are multiplying here? Just the property says here the multiplicative inverse. So you have to multiply one number such that you have to get the result as 1. What is that number? That number we call it as a multiplicative inverse of the given number. Let us consider two examples here. Consider 1 by 3. You have to multiply one number such that you have to get the result as 1. Consider few more numbers. Minus 2 by 3. You have to multiply one number such that you have to get the result as 1. Consider 0. You have to multiply one number such that you have to get the result as 1. So here, what is the number you have to multiply such that you are getting the result as 1? Just you have to take the reciprocal of the given number. What is meant by the reciprocal? If you have given any number in the form of the fraction, just you have to interchange the denominator and the numerator. Then we will get the reciprocal of the given number. What is the reciprocal of 3 by 1? Which is nothing but 1 by 3. What is the reciprocal of 1 by 3? Which is nothing but 3 by 1. Right? And what is the reciprocal of minus 2 by 3? Which is nothing but minus 3 by 2. Just you have to interchange the numerator and the denominator. What is the inverse of 0? You can write 0 as 0 by 1, 0 by 2, 0 by 3. You can write the denominator any number such that you are getting the result as 0. So what is the inverse of 0 by 1? Which is nothing but 1 by 0. Right? Now let us solve this. Here, after cancellation, what we are getting here, the result as 1. Here also, after solving, this 3 will get cancelled. You are getting the result as 1. Here, this 2 will get cancelled. 3 will get cancelled. And you know that minus into minus is plus. So, you are getting here the result as 1. Now, check for this one. Is it possible here? Here, let us consider here 0. And here, what we are getting here, 0 by 1. We are taking 0 as 0 by 1. Now we are writing the reciprocal of this number. What we are getting here? 1 by 0. You know that 1 by 0 is not possible. This value is undefined. So we can say that the multiplicative inverse of 0 does not exist. Now what is, how you now state this property? How do you state this property here? Consider one rational number A. Then what this property says, a into 1 by a must be equal to 1 by a into a is equal to 1. This property we call it as a multiplicative inverse. And here you can write as a is the multiplicative inverse of a. Like this you can define. In the examination they will ask what is the multiplicative inverse of 5. Then you can mention it as 1 by 5. Suppose they will ask what is the multiplicative inverse of 2 by 5. Then you can write it as 5 by 2. Just you have to write the reciprocal of the given number so that you are getting the multiplicative inverse of the given number. The next property, which is the last property, which is distributive property. What is distributive property says here? The name itself says we are distributing one number to the given numbers. Here let us consider three rational numbers A, B, C. What is property says here? A into B plus C. Here we are distributing this A to both of these numbers. How we are distributing here? Just multiply A with both these numbers. What you are getting here? A into B plus A into C. This property we call it as a distributive property. What the distributive property says, if you consider any three rational numbers, let us consider those rational numbers as A, B, C. What it states, if A, comma B, comma C belongs to Q, then we can state that A into B plus C must be equal to A into B plus A into C. Let us solve this by taking the example. Let us consider one example, 1 by 2, 3 by 2, and 5 by 2. You know that all these are rational numbers. Now check the LHS and the RHS part. Take the A value as 1 by 2 and the B value as 3 by 2 and the C value as 5 by 2. Now check for LHS. What is LHS here? You have to solve A into B plus C. So here, what is the value of A here? 1 by 2 into, and what is the value of B here? 3 by 2. And what is the value of C here? 5 by 2. How do you solve this one? Just you have to solve what is there in the brackets first. You have to take the LCM of 2 and 2. What is the LCM of 2 and 2? Which is nothing but 2. Since the denominator is same, you can directly add the numerators. So what you will get in here? 3 plus 5. You know that what is the value of 3 plus 5? 8. Right? So here, now what we have to do? Just you have to multiply these numbers. What you will get? 1 into 8, which is 8, and 2 into 2, which is 4. What is the value of 8 by 4, which is nothing but 2. Now solve for RHS. So RHS, which number you have to take here? A into B plus A into C. Just substitute the values of A, B, C here. What is the value of A here? 1 into 2. And what is the value of B here? 3 by 2. Here, what is the value of A? 1 by 2. And what is the value of C? 5 by 2. Now, solve these numbers. How do you solve? Again, first you have to solve what is there in the brackets first. So here, we are multiplying two fractions. How do you multiply two fractions? Just you have to multiply the numerator and you have to multiply the denominator. So what you will get here? 1 into 3, which is 3. 2 into 2, which is 4. Now, solve this one. 1 into 5, which is 5, and after that here 2 into 2, which is 4. So here, after taking take the denominator as 4. Now how do you solve? Just you have to add these numbers. After adding these numbers, what you get here? 5 plus 3, 8 by 4. So after solving, what you are getting here? 2. So if you take the LHS, you are getting the result as 2. And if you take the RHS, you are getting the result as 2. From this, what we can conclude here? LHS, left hand side, must be equal to the right hand side. What is the LHS here? So just write here 1 by 2 into 3 by 2 plus 5 by 2 must be equal to 1 by 2 into 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 5 by 2. So from this what we can conclude here, we are taking three rational numbers and we are distributing this 1 by 2 to both of these numbers such that we are getting 1 by 2 into 3 by 2 plus 5 by 2 must be equal to 1 by 2 into 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 5 by 2. This property we call it as a distributive property. These are the properties of the rational numbers. In the next session, we are going to discuss few problems about the rational numbers.